People say the Jordan 1s are dying or dead. I just think it's a regression to normality, a regression to the mean. I think the past few years have been exceptions. I feel like this is closer to normal. This Jordan 1, these earthy tones, oh, kind of went under the radar, but I really like them. Air Jordan 1 Dusted Clay. And this shoe dropped on March 6th for $200. It is a woman's exclusive. And I just gotta say right off the bat, first impressions, I love the colors on the shoe. They're very earthy tones. Officially, the colors are Cacao Wow and Choco Fantastique, or Choco Fantastic. Do it that way you will. For me, it's just brown and shades of brown. Very earthy, especially in the fall in New England where I live. I just think this is perfect for that time of the year. But overall, I love the colors on the shoe. It kind of reminds me of the Nike Dunk Red Pandas that came out late last year. I did not like that shoe at all, mainly because of how they arranged the colors. The color blocking, it just didn't really appeal to me. But for this, even though it's similar, I just think for the Jordan 1s on this silhouette, these colors look really, really nice. And the materials on the shoe, it is nice. It is a suede upper sole, very nice feeling suede, especially the overlays. Feels nice and soft and smooth. I personally don't love that very hairy type of suede or that rough dry suede. This suede feels good. And what's interesting about the shoe, and I guess that's why they justify the $200 price point for the shoe, it is the tongue. It is a satin tongue with Nike Air branding on the tag, of course, at the top, as well as a satin ankle collar lining. Obviously going for a more luxurious and upscale vibe. And I gotta say, it kinda works. It just looks and feels very, very nice. I really like how the Nike Air tag is the same color or nearly the same color as the tongue and the laces. Just kinda blends in. Very well done. I love the colors on the shoe. And of course you got the Wings logo also in suede. It is suede that's debossed into the shoe. So like in the shoe, it doesn't pop out. And the Jordan 1s comes with a rubber cup sole with a Nike Air unit on the heel. And the cup sole itself, it does match the base layer in terms of color. So I like that. It's not like a random sale. If they did that, I would just, yeah, I would have lost it. But same color as the base layer, so it just fits right in. And of course, the iconic Jordan 1 outsole in that same reddish brown color. I think that dark brown would have looked really nice for the outsole as well, but this works. And the shoe does come with one extra set of laces. Thank God, if I'm paying $20 more for a Jordan 1, they better come with some extras. And the extra laces in that same dark brown color, out of the two, I think they both look really nice. I think I still prefer how it looks out of the box, but can't really go wrong with that dark brown. Every color on the shoe, I think, just works. Now, something they also threw in is this bag. And I gotta say, the material on the bag feels kind of nice too. Kind of like a suede finish. And like satin lining, and the drawstrings also has these gold lace tips. That's a nice touch there too. Kind of wish they did these gold lace tips for the shoe, like itself. Don't know why they didn't do that. And the box of the shoe, a very sleek and clean white Nike box. And in terms of sizing and comfort, I'm a size 9.5 true to size. I do have wide and flat feet. For Jordan 1s, I stick true to size, and it fits pretty well in terms of the width. I will say that satin lining around the ankle collar might give the shoe like a more slippery feel. You might feel like your feet's kind of coming in and out or slipping out. So if you're one of those people that like to wear their laces super loose and you don't have super wide feet, maybe consider going down half a size. But for me, if I had to make a recommendation, I'd say go true to size and just tighten up those laces. Now, overall comfort, the Jordan 1's not the most comfortable. A rubber cup sole that is ancient, pretty heavy, not very responsive, doesn't provide much cushioning. Just one Nike Air unit on the heel. But I think for casual use here and there, it's not a huge problem, but definitely not one of the more comfortable shoes. And that brings the total sole score of the Air Jordan 1 Dusted Clay to 32 out of 40. Pretty good score compared to other general releases. Now first, it is colorway. This is subjective, but the earthy tones are just right up my alley. The use of the dark brown and that light sandy color for the base layer, it just works really well. I think the color blocking and the fact that they matched the sole to the rest of the upper sole, they didn't go with a random sale color. I love the colorway of the shoe. It's so nice. And in terms of the materials, pleasantly surprised. The satin lining around the ankle collar and the tongue is nice if you're into that. That's not like a huge plus for me. I don't mind it, but it's not like I love that type of material on shoes. But the rest of the upper sole, it feels smooth. It feels nice. It feels good. $200 is a lot of money for an Air Jordan 1, but At least that extra $10, you can maybe justify it, but it's still kind of sick that Jordan Brand sets expectations pretty low for $180 for a Jordan 1, and then when you pay extra, comes with nice materials. Comes with materials that surprise you. The only thing that's not the best is, of course, the tech specs of a Jordan 1. It's very old, doesn't hold up as well in 2024. And that leads me to comfort. Jordan 1s are pretty average, I think, in terms of comfort. Like around your feet, the ankle collar padding is very nice, but the cushioning and just the feel of the shoe, still very flat to the ground. It's kind of stiff, not very responsive. I know some people do find it a pretty comfortable shoe. For me, I think it's very average. And in terms of the versatility, the Jordan 1's still a very, very wearable silhouette. Can't get more wearable than this. And in terms of the wearability of the colorway, I think earthy tones are generally very wearable. It's not everyone's thing, but objectively, it's very versatile, especially during like fall. It's just a super wearable shoe. Again, doesn't appeal to everybody, but I think it's easy to make this work. Honestly, I think this is one of my favorite Jordan 1's of 2024, at least so far. Can't think of one off the top of my head that I like more than this one. Maybe the Jordan 1 Low 85 Navy. But yeah, I really like these. It's not an OG colorway or anything. It's not a re-release of a beloved colorway that came out before. It's just nice. These earthy tones, they get me every time. So that's it. Thanks for watching. Soul Inclined. Let me know what you think of the Air Jordan 1 Dusted Clay. Like, subscribe, comment, all the good stuff. And remember, tomorrow may never come, so wear your shoes.